video, we will start a new lesson from your Cambridge book, that is Rip Van Winkle, which is written by Washington Irving, who was American story writer. So first, let us discuss this warm-up part. Scientists have revealed that sleep is as necessary for our health as exercise. We all love to sleep, especially when it is time to go to school. So scientists have said that sleep is very important for our health. Sleep is as necessary as exercise for our health. And especially children feel very sleepy at the time of school. So let us discuss these questions, basic questions which are related to sleep. What time do you go to bed at night? Means at what time do you sleep at night? How long do you sleep? Means how many hours do you sleep at night? Do you fall asleep in class? What do you say when someone wakes you up in the morning? So answer all these questions to yourself. So let us start the lesson. Let us read first. Whoever has made a voyage up the Hudson River may remember the Catskill Mountains. They can be seen to the west of the river, swelling up to a noble height and lording it over the surrounding country. So voyage means what? Voyage means journey. So in this whole lesson, there are many highlighted words. Okay, you will find many words in this lesson. So all these words meanings are given on that same page. See, here you will find meaning, and on every page meanings are given. So you can go through all those meanings later. Okay. Now let us discuss this. So here it is said that whoever has made journey to Hudson River, that person may remember the Catskill Mountains. Catskill Mountains can be seen to the west of the Hudson River. Catskill Mountains are expanded up to a great height and standing high above the surrounding country. Understood? So now let us read this part first. At the foot of these mountains, the voyager means traveler, okay? At the foot of these mountains, the voyager may have seen the light smoke curling up from a village, whose shingle roofs gleam among the trees. It is a little village of great antiquity, having been founded by some Dutch colonist in the early times. So let me explain this first. So here it is said that at the foot of Catskill Mountains means what? At the base of the Catskill Mountains, the traveler can see the light smoke coming from a village whose roofs shine among the trees. It's a very little village that has been there for long time, okay, since many years. That village, which is founded by some Dutch colonist in the early times, okay. So now let us discuss this part. In that same village, there lived, while the country was yet a province of Great Britain, a simple, good-natured fellow by the name of Rip Van Winkle. He was an unselfish man, a kind neighbor, and an obedient husband. Dame Van Winkle was, on the contrary, known throughout the neighborhood as a woman with a fiery temper and a sharp tongue. Okay, so let us discuss this first. So here it is said that in that same village, there lived a simple, good-natured man, Rip Van Winkle. He was unselfish. Unselfish means selfless. He was selfless, kind neighbor, and an obedient husband. Obedient husband means what? The husband which listens to his wife. And on the contrary, okay? On the contrary means exactly opposite. His wife, whose name was Dame Van Winkle. His wife, Dame Van Winkle, who was completely opposite in nature of her husband. She was known throughout the neighborhood as a woman who easily becomes angry and shouts loudly. Okay? So now let us discuss this part. Rip was a great favorite with the villagers, particularly with the children, who would shout with joy whenever he approached. He assisted at their sports, made their playthings, taught them to fly kites and shoot marbles, and told them stories of ghosts and witches. So let me explain this first. So Rip was a great favorite with the villagers, and especially with the children. So he would always help children at their sports. He taught them to fly kites and shoot marbles, and he told them many stories. Okay? Now let us discuss this. The great error in Rip's composition. Composition means personality. The great error in Rip's composition was an aversion to all kinds of profitable labor. It could not be from want of perseverance, for he would sit on a wet rock with a heavy rod and fish all day without a murmur, even though he was not encouraged by a single neighbor. Okay, let us discuss this first. Aversion means dislike. All these meanings are given on this same page. Okay, you can read and go through all these difficult words meanings. Okay, now let me explain this first. So what happened? Rip Van Winkle, he had one bad quality in his personality. What was that bad quality? He did not like any kind of money making or profit making job and hard work. Okay, he did not like doing anything. Okay, he was very lazy man. He would just sit on a wet rock with a heavy rod and fish all day without speaking anything. Okay, without a murmur means what? Without speaking anything. Understood? So now let us discuss this part. Let us read first. He would carry a fowling piece on his shoulder for hours together, trudging through woods and swamps and uphill and down dale to shoot a few squirrel or wild pigeons. Okay, so let us discuss this first. Fowling piece means what? Fowling piece means shotgun. Okay, so Rip Van Winkle, he would always carry a shotgun on his shoulder, and he would walk through woods and up hills and down valley to shoot squirrels or wild pigeons. Okay, understood? So he would always carry a shotgun with him, and he would always shoot squirrels and wild pigeons. Okay, so now let us discuss this. He would never refuse to assist a neighbor even in roughest toil. In a word, Rip was ready to attend to anybody's business but his own. So let us discuss this. He would never refuse to help a neighbor even in their bad time or in hard work. He would always assist, always help his neighbors. Okay, now let us read this first. Rip Van Winkle was one of those happy mortals. Mortal means humans. who take the world easy, eat white bread or brown, whichever can be got with least thought or trouble. He would have loved to whistle life away in perfect contentment. But his wife kept dinning in his ears about his idleness, his carelessness, and the ruin he was bringing upon his family. So let us discuss this. Listen attentively. So, Rip was one of those happy people who take the world easy. He would eat white or brown bread, whichever got, with least trouble. Okay, he would have enjoyed his life in perfect manner, but his wife always shout at him about his idleness and carelessness and his laziness. Okay, he was always idle. Okay, he did not work. Okay, he would not do anything. That is why his wife would always shout at him. So now let us read this first. Poor Rip was driven to despair. Despair means sadness or nirasha. Okay, his only alternative to escape from the labor of the farm and clamor of his wife was to take the gun in hand and stroll away into the woods, accompanied by his dog, whose name was Wolf. Let us discuss this first. Okay. So what happened? Poor Rip would become sad sometimes, okay? And to escape from the hard work of farm and his wife's loud noise, he would walk away. Stroll means walk, okay? He would walk away in woods with the gun in his hand and along with his dog. His dog's name was Wolf. Understood? So, he would always carry gun in his hand, okay, and he would go with his dog, Wolf, in wood, okay. Let us read this first. On one of his long rambles, Rip had unconsciously scrambled up to one of the highest parts of the Catskill Mountains. He was at his favorite sport of squirrel shooting. When he was tired, he sat down on green knoll. He could see miles of rich woodland and far below him flowing majestically the Hudson. So let us discuss this first. So what happened? On one of his long walks, Rip climbed up to the highest parts of the Catskill Mountains, and he was shooting squirrel, which was his favorite sport. When he was tired, he sat down on a green hill. He could see miles of rich woodland and the Hudson River, which was flowing majestically, okay? So, where he sat on that top portion or on the mountain, he could see all the woodland and the river which was flowing down, okay? Wait. Now, let us read this first. It was getting dark as he was about to descend. He heard a voice from a distance calling Rip Van Winkle. He looked around but could see nothing but a crow winging its solitary flight across the mountain. He thought his fancy must have deceived him and turned again to descend when he heard the same cry ring through the still evening air. Rip Van Winkle, Rip Van Winkle. Old bristled his back and growled, looking fearfully down into the glen. Rip felt a vague apprehension. Apprehension means fear. So let me explain this first. So what happened? It was evening time and it was getting dark As he was stepping down from the mountain, he heard a voice from a distance calling Rip Van Winkle. So he looked around, but he could see only a crow flying alone across the mountains. He thought his imagination tricked him and again heard the same voice, Rip Van Winkle, Rip Van Winkle. His dog was scared and his dog went down into the valley. Even Rip was also scared. Okay. So now let us discuss this. Suddenly he saw a strange figure climbing up the rocks with a heavy burden on his back. Rip was surprised to see any human being in his lonely and unfrequented place. So let us discuss this first. So what happened? Suddenly Rip saw a strange man climbing up the rocks with heavy burden on his back. Rip was surprised to see that man in such a lonely place. Okay. Now let us read this first. The stranger means ajnabi. Okay. Anorkhi manto na apan marathi. Okay. The stranger was singular in appearance. Appearance means look. Okay. The stranger was singular in appearance. He was a short, old fellow with thick bushy hair and grizzled beard. He was dressed in antique Dutch fashion. Antique means old. A cloth jerkin strapped around the waist and a pair of breeches. He bore on his shoulder a stout. Stout means heavy. He bore on his shoulder a stout keg. Keg means barrel. That seemed to be full of some drink. He made signs for Rip to approach and assist him with the load. So let us discuss this first. So what happened? The stranger means ajnabi. The stranger was unusual in appearance. Okay. He was very short, an old man with thick bushy hair and grayish beard. He was dressed in old Dutch fashion. His jerkin and a pair of trousers tied around his waist. He carried a heavy barrel which was full of drink on his shoulder, and he made signs for Rip to help with the load. Okay. Now let us read this. The two labored on in silence up the wild mountain, mutually relieving one another of the load till they came to a hollow surrounded by mountains. Here Rip saw some odd-looking people dressed in quaint outlandish fashion, playing ninepins. All of them had beards of various shapes and colors. Rip's companion now emptied the contents of the cake into large flagons. Flagon means what? Container. Rip was tempted to taste the draught. When he had drunk as much as he wanted to, he fell into a deep sleep. Now let us discuss this. So what happened? Rip helped that old man to carry the heavy barrel till they came to a valley. Then Rip saw some odd-looking people who dressed in old and unusual fashion. All those people, they were playing ninepins. All of them had beards of various shapes and different colors. Rip's companion means who? That old man. He emptied the heavy barrel of drink into a large container. And Rip was attracted to taste that drink. And he had drunk as much as he wanted. Okay. Rip Van Winkle had drunk that drink as much as he wanted to, and he fell into a deep sleep. Okay, understood? So now let us read this first. On waking, he found himself on the green knoll where he had first seen the old man of the glen. He rubbed his eyes. It was a bright sunny morning. The birds were happily twittering among the bushes. Okay, bushes means a kind of it's a plant. Okay, plants, trees, plants. So let us discuss this part first. Okay, so what happened when he woke up, Rip Van Winkle woke up from sleep? He rubbed his eyes and it was a bright sunny morning. Okay, sunny morning means there were morning sun rays. Okay, he woke up, it was a bright sunny morning. The birds were happily twittering among the bushes. And then he recalled the memories before he fell asleep. Okay, he recalled all the memories of previous night. Okay, he recalled the memories before he fell asleep. Then he started walking and he felt pain in his joints, and he could not walk in his usual active manner. When he got down into the valley with difficulty, he found the trench. Okay, trench means nali jo bolte na waisa. Okay, which he and the old man crossed the previous evening. Okay, understood? So he woke up from sleep and he started walking, and there was pain in his joints. Okay, so understood? Now let us read this part first. So what happened? So we have already discussed this. Okay, understood? So there was pain in his joints. Now let us discuss this. Now let us read this first. His dog too was nowhere to be seen, and strangely enough, his beard had grown a foot long. So see, let us discuss these two lines. His dog was nowhere, okay, which was there with him previous day, okay, Wolf. So his dog was nowhere and his beard had grown a foot long. Have you understood? His beard had grown 1 foot long. Okay, now let us discuss this. Let us read this first. Rip entered the outskirts of his village, which was strangely altered. Altered means changed. And outskirt means what? Outskirts means the outside of the village, outside area of the village. Okay, so he entered in the outskirts of his village and he found that his village was completely changed, strangely changed. It was larger and more populous. Populous means crowded. Okay, there was that area was more crowded, okay, than before. His familiar haunts had disappeared. Instead, there were rows of houses which he had never seen. Okay, haunts means what? Places. His familiar places had disappeared, and instead of that, there were rows of houses which he had never seen. Okay, so basically, he had found lot of changes in his village. Okay, even there were his familiar places also disappeared, and there were rows of houses which he had never seen before. So now let us read on the next page. So that drink last night, thought Rip, has addled my poor head sadly. So he thought that drink which he had drunk last night confused his poor head sadly. Okay, now let us read this first. Rip entered his house. It was empty, apparently abandoned. He called loudly for his wife and children. There was nothing but silence. The villagers had gathered round him, but Rip could not recognize anyone. So let us discuss this part. So what happened, you know? When Rip entered his house, it was empty and even there was no owner. Okay. He called loudly for his wife and children, but there was nothing. No one was there. Only silence. The villagers had gathered around him, but Rip could not recognize anyone. Okay. Now let us read this first. At this moment, a young woman with a child in her arms pressed through the throng. Throng means crowd, to take a look at him. The child began to cry when he saw Rip's strange appearance. So what happened, students? At that moment, a young woman with a child in her arms, she came forward through the crowd to look at Rip Van Winkle. Okay. The child began to cry when he saw Rip's strange appearance. Okay. That child started crying when he saw Rip's strange appearance. Okay. Now let us read this. Okay. So let us read this first. "Hush, Rip," she cried. "The old man won't hurt you." The name of the child and the tone of his mother's voice awakened a train of recollections in Rip Van Winkle's mind. So what happened? That woman said to her child, "Hush, Rip," she said, "the old man won't hurt you." Okay? Means, do you know that that woman's child name was also Rip? Okay? And what happened? The name of that child and the tone of her and the tone of his mother's voice. Okay, name of child and that woman's voice, tone of her voice, awakened many memories in Rip Van Winkle's mind. Okay, so all those things awakened many memories in Rip's mind, in Rip Van Winkle's mind. So let us discuss further. So listen, now what happens, Rip Van Winkle asks few questions to that woman. So he asked, "What is your name?" So she replied, "Juliet Garnier." And then Rip asked her, "And your father's name?" Then she said, "Rip Van Winkle was his name." Okay, that woman replied, "Rip Van Winkle was his name, but it's 20 years since he went away from home. He has never been heard of since. His dog came back without him. I was then a little girl." Okay, so let me explain this first. So what happened, students? He asked that woman, "What is your name?" She replied, "Juliet Garnier." Then he asked her, "What is your father's name?" Rip Van Winkle was his name, but it has been 20 years since he went away from home. His dog came back without him when I was a little girl. Okay. Then what happened? Then Rip asked her, asked that woman her mother's name. Where is your mother? Not name. He asked, "Where is your mother?" Then that woman replied, "Oh, she died some time ago." Okay. So understood what happened? Then that woman replied, "Oh, she died some time ago." So later what happened, you know? Rip caught his daughter and her child in his arms. "I'm your father, young Rip Van Winkle once, old Rip Van Winkle now." You know what happened? Rip Van Winkle caught his daughter and her child in his arms and he said to that woman, "I'm your father, old Rip Van Winkle now. Once I was young Rip Van Winkle, but now I am old." So I understood what happened. So you know, it means Rip Van Winkle slept for 20 years on that mountain. You know, he had drunk that drink from that old man, and then he slept for 20 years. And then he came back to his village, okay? And his wife was died. His that little daughter became very old, okay? And his daughter even had a baby. And no one recognized him. And his whole village was changed. Understood? So all these things happened in 20 years. Now let us read this. Sure enough, it is Rip Van Winkle. Welcome home again. Where have you been these 20 long years? Said an old woman who had trotted along to see him. So what happened? There was one old woman. She said, "It is Rip Van Winkle. Welcome home again. Where have you been these 20 long years?" Rip, then what happened? Rip related his strange experience to them. Okay. So means what happened? Rip shared his whole strange experience to them. Okay. He told whole that incident that he saw old man and he had drunk from his barrel. Okay. And then he slept and directly slept for 20 years and then he got up and he came to village. Okay. He shared his whole experience to all the villagers. So, it was Peter Wonderdonk, the most ancient inhabitant of the village, who affirmed that the Catskill Mountains had always been haunted by strange beings. Rip's daughter, who was married to a farmer, took her father home where Rip lived happily. So students, what happened at the end, you know? There was one old villager, okay? Villager, his name was Peter Wonderdog, okay, and he said Catskill Mountains had always been haunted by some strange beings, okay. And what happened at the end? Rip's daughter, who was married to one farmer, okay, then she took her father at her house, and Rip Van Winkle lived happily for rest of his life. So students, here our whole lesson is completed. So we will stop here. Bye. Have a great day.